be able to have the opportunity to play president of all the Barbies, even though all Barbies can do anything and are capable of everything, to be able to wear my presidential sash and in my mind rule and kick it over Barbie Land is a treat. And it's so much fun playing her. Everything's just so optimistic and positive in the Barbie world. So the president is doing a good job maintaining that, I'd imagine. Does she even have to do anything? Who knows? She might. The president passes bills all day and every day, and that's why Barbie Land gets to be what it is. So I'm going to take full credit. I reverse what I said initially. President Barbie does everything. President Barbie is different because her hair, I would say, fluctuates a lot. She might have a large Afro wig. She might have a slinky curly wig, like texture changes. So her outfits change just as much as her hair does. To be able to be transformed into a Barbie, you know, hearing Ivana talk about like the eyes in particular and making sure that they felt doll-like, and talking to Dumemi, my makeup artist, about like making sure that was showcased, and from that straight Barbie eyebrows to, you know, obviously the hair, and the bigger the better. And I've never had big hair. First of all, it's heavy. Like, my neck is kind of shooting back in this. But it's, once you see it as a whole, you're just like, okay, yes, I believe that all of these women are dolls and all of these men are Kens. And it really is, there's such subtleties to becoming these Barbie dolls. The Barbies are absolutely amazing. When I first walk on set, I was like, oh, they have been here for a couple weeks. So I was like kind of nervous, like, oh, they've already bonded. I missed that time. But everybody is the nicest and so welcoming. And, you know, we've gone out a couple of times. There's always an opportunity to just hang. And it's just laughs in between takes, during takes sometimes. And it's just really genuinely fun to watch everybody's interpretation of being a Barbie and being a Ken. And I just get so much enjoyment. There's not one scene that I've been a part of that hasn't made me crack up laughing. Anyone who has talked to me since I've been on this movie can tell you that I've sung Greta's praises. It really is, from the moment you meet her, from the moment you walk onto her set, it is such a warm, inviting environment. And I don't know if that's just because it's the Barbie movie and it's the Barbie world, but I doubt that. I feel like it really is just her, and it's such a comforting place to be able to take chances. You know, she's so funny and also just full of stories that may impact how you make a decision, how you make a specific acting choice. And it's just one of the best sets I've ever been on, if not the best. I love that Greta and team took the time to make sure that all Barbies were represented in, you know, across spectrums, across body types, and across backgrounds. And it doesn't feel forced. This is Barbie, you know, this is the Barbie that I've come to know, from my parents making sure that I had a black Barbie growing up, from, you know, seeing the representation of all different types of Barbies as I've gotten older, and being able to reflect that in this movie. And I'm sure we didn't cover everything. It's impossible to, but there's the acknowledgement of that. And, you know, I really value that, and I appreciate that. It's a beautiful thing to witness.